A lesson from Aaron. Sonia is moved to head Vaughn department and Vaughn is not happy about it. Sonia was still a little child when he started working in that department. Why should he be expected to report to such a person? True, Sonia went to college and he did not, but he has been the supervisor of that department for a long time. To suddenly have a little girl sitting above him is totally unacceptable. However, the order came from above, so there is nothing Vaughn can do. He's not going to resign either because he needs the job to pay his bills. Vaughn does all he can to make things difficult for Sonia. Every suggestion she brings is met with serious opposition, and so does every effort she makes to break the wall of partition Vaughn builds to separate himself from her. Vaughn does not stop at being mean and unfriendly to Sonia, but also tries to incite other employees in their department to do the same. Even though nobody else seems to see things from Vaughn's perspective, he is bent on never cooperating with Sonia. What Vaughn did to Sonia is, unfortunately, what a lot of Christian brothers and sisters do to their church leaders. Some people feel that a person who is younger biologically should never be their leader. If people like that happen to know that their pastor is younger, they do whatever they can to frustrate him. They sometimes start by trying to control the pastor as they will control their younger sibling. If the pastor chooses to go God's way, where there is a conflict between what God wants and what the big brothers and sisters want, they begin to see him as a proud, disrespectful boy, and the battle line is drawn. Some rebel against their church leader if they know that they gave their lives to Christ before him. A lot of times, people who do this believe that they are spiritually superior to their pastor or departmental head and should actually be the ones occupying the leadership position. Why should they have to take orders from someone who is beneath them in terms of the anointing and power of the Holy Spirit? However, if you cannot submit to whoever is above you, then you do not have the maturity needed to be a leader. If for any reason you find yourself opposing your pastor or leader, either in your heart only or also with your actions and words, you need to have a rethink. Look above and beyond your pastor and see the God that placed him on the altar. Psalm 115 verse 3 says that our God is in heaven and he does whatever pleases him. If he has chosen someone you think is not qualified to be your leader, believe that he knows what he is doing. There are people in whom God has invested a lot, but until they are given a challenging responsibility, they may never take the time to discover and develop what is in them. Putting them in leadership position may be God's way of getting them to break up their fallow ground and begin to seek him more. Examples abound of people who only started taking their service to God very seriously after they were entrusted with a higher responsibility. Isaiah chapter 55 verses 8 and 9. The Lord says, "My thoughts are not like yours, your ways are not like mine. Just as the heavens are higher than the earth, so my ways are higher than your ways, and my thoughts are higher than your thoughts." Please believe that God knows what he is doing and see yourself as cooperating with him when you cooperate with your leader. Always bear Colossians chapter 3 verse 17 in mind. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Exodus chapter 7 verse 7. Moses was 80 years old and Aaron 83 when they spoke to Pharaoh. Aaron was 3 years older than Moses. However, God chose Moses. And even after Moses told God that he could not speak to Pharaoh because of his stammering, the Lord said to him, "What about your brother, Aaron the Levite? I know he can speak well. He is already on his way to meet you. He will be glad to see you. Speak to him. Put your words in his mouth. Tell him what to say. I will help both of you speak. I will teach you what to do. He will speak to the people for you. He will be like your mouth, and you will be like God to him." That's Exodus chapter 4, verses 14 to 16. In spite of the fact that Moses was younger than Aaron and also stammered, Aaron was subject to him. Even when Moses queried him for making an idol for the Israelites to worship while Moses was on the mountain, Aaron said to him, "Do not be angry, my Lord. You know how prone these people are to evil." That is Exodus 32:22. He actually addressed his younger brother as "my Lord." That was a big sign of humility. You may say that Moses was chosen by God and so Aaron had no choice than to respect and cooperate with him. You believe that your own pastor got to the altar through the back door and so you cannot submit to him because he's not in the same category as Moses, a true man of God. If that is your thinking, you have to understand that whether your pastor was chosen by God or by man, he is the leader of the church. All you can do is pray and let God handle things his own way. May the Lord give us wisdom in Jesus' name.